Hello, this is a tutorial on how to install the correct driver for your Motic cam or your Motic microscope for Windows 7 or Windows Vista. If you have not already, please try following the instructions from the other video for installing the correct driver automatically onto Windows 7 or Windows Vista. You will also need to download the software. The instructions for that is also inside the other video. Once you have downloaded the software as a zip folder, please extract it into your desktop, plus 2.0 for PC. The driver that we will need to manually install is inside that software. This will also apply to Motic Play or Motic Educator. Today I will be using a Motic Cam 2300 as an example. The steps still apply to any Motic product that is compliant with Windows 7 or Windows Vista. You can check if your Motic Cam or Motic microscope will work with Windows 7 by the link in the description below. Now I'll try to plug in the USB cable. Windows should automatically detect my software and my camera and try to install it. I'll click on the pop-up button here. It should fail, as it does. So what I need to do is close this window. Go to the start menu, click on start menu, right click on computer, then click on properties, and then click on device manager. Once we get here, there's four places we would want to search for our Motic device. One is imaging devices, which may or may not pop up. In this case, it has not. Other devices, which my Motic Cam 2300 shows up in, Motic USB 2.0. For cameras with video outputs, it may show up in sound, video, and game controllers. And the last one you may want to check is Universal Serial Bus Controller. Just go inside, just check for sure. How we know for sure that Motic USB 2.0 is the Motic Cam 2300 that I have is to unplug the USB cable. Device Manager should refresh itself, and Motic USB 2.0 should disappear. Now we know for sure that we have located our device. Now plug in back the USB cable, and Motic USB 2.0 shows up again. What we need to do is right click on whatever device it is. It may be TV Walkie QQ, it may be Motic USB 2.0 as in my case. But the important part is to right click on it, click update driver, and then click on browse my computer for driver software, and then click on let me pick from a list of device drivers on my computer. Once you get to this part, click on imaging devices, and then click on have disk, and click on browse, and browse to your desktop or wherever you saved your software to, the extracted version. In my case, it was the desktop. Click on plus 2.0 for PC, and then this version number may be different for your software. What's important is that you go inside and find the driver folder. For my case, I will need to use Motic USB 2 camera. It may not be the same for you. Please check the driver chart in the description below, in the link below, sorry, and check which exact driver you will need. Once you get in, there should be only one file you can click on. In my case, it's Motic USB 2 camera. It may not be the same for you. What's important is there's only one file you can click on. Double click on that and then click OK. And then click Next. Windows will warn you that this software is not digitally signed. I can assure you there's nothing wrong with this the driver. Just click on install this driver software anyways. For efficiency purposes, I will now post a video. Once the driver has done downloading or installing itself, sorry, you will get to this page. Windows has finished installing the driver software from this device, Motic USB2 Camera. What you need to do, it may ask you to restart the computer, it may not, depends on the computer. Either way, if it does ask you to restart, restart. If it doesn't, just click close. And now, inside Device Manager, under Imaging Devices, your camera for your microscope or your Modicam will show up. In my case, it says Motic USB2 Camera. Now, to test out our camera, please open up Motic Images Plus, the software you installed already, most likely. Once you open up Motic Images Plus, you may get a gray background interface or a blue background interface in my case. What you need to do is click on Capture for the blue interface. For the gray interface, click on File and then Capture Window. Then we will get to this Motic Imaging Live module. As you can see right now, I get a white screen that's too big for my view to view. What's important to note is under Video Devices, the box in here does say something. In my case, it says Motic 3.0 MP. It may not be the same for you. What's important is it does say something in this box. That's how you know for sure that your software is talking to your camera. And also another thing to note is your FPS, or your frames per second, is higher than 0.0. That's another clear sign that your software is talking to your camera. What I need to do to get a picture now is just to click on Auto Exposure. Oh, I cleared out my picture a bit. And also to click on Fit to Window so I can see all that's in view. Right now I have my Modicam 2300 looking at a pen. As you can see, it's still overexposed and out of focus. What I need to do for the out of focus part is just to twist the 16mm lens to get into focus. Okay, now that it's in better focus, I just need to check the exposure. Okay. You can adjust in general to get a high frames per second, which is 19 right now, so as you can see, it's a very smooth video. Is to have a low exposure, and you can adjust compensate for the low exposure because it gets darker by a high gain. As you can see, or you can, as I go higher in exposure, my frames per second will go down, but it's too bright now anyway, so I'll go back down. Come here, and then I'll compensate with my gain. As you can see, 19 frames per second. If I use my maximum resolution, 2048 times 1536, which is a very, very big picture. Very, very big. Double the size of what I was using before, I will get half my frames per second. So as you can see, my frames per second will be a bit slower now. And that's how you get your Modicam or Motic microscope up and running. Thank you.